welcome, and let's greet each other with signs of peace and open worship.
Blessed be your name in the land that is plentiful, where your streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name when I'm found in the desert place. Though I walk through the wilderness, blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be your name when the sun's shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name. Thank you.
And at this time, as we reflect on our last week and time, help us to come before God with those things that are on our hearts that we know that maybe we could have done differently or we would like to have done differently, and know that God is there. So let's take a minute in silent prayer. God, who is the source of light and life, knows that you are forgiven people. Amen.
Let's pray. Prions le Seigneur. Dieu créateur, nous te rendons grâce, nous te disons merci pour cette belle journée. Nous t'élevons, nous te glorifions, mon Dieu, mon roi. Nous te disons merci puisque tu es au milieu de nous. Seigneur, aujourd'hui c'est une grande journée pour t'adorer, pour te glorifier. Seigneur, nous disons merci puisque ton Esprit Saint, Esprit de délivrance, Esprit de paix, Esprit de justice, Esprit qui élève la nation. Ô Seigneur, bénis cette belle journée. Nous voulons que cet Esprit Saint soit en exercice aujourd'hui dans la prédication, dans les chants, dans nos prières. Seigneur, nous te remercions pour la guérison du pasteur Rafa. Nous prions pour ceux qui sont dans les hospices. Nous prions pour ceux qui sont dans les churches aujourd'hui. Nous prions pour ceux qui sont dans les prisons. Nous prions pour ceux qui souffrent énormément dans les guerres perpétuées. Que ta main soit longue pour nous sauver. Que ta main soit longue pour sauver la nation congolaise. Ô Seigneur, qui peut comme toi? Le Dieu qui guérit, le Dieu qui sanctifie, le Dieu qui purifie. C'est pourquoi nous t'appelons Jéhovah Rapha. Nous t'appelons Alpha Omega. Nous t'appelons Jéhovah Nissi, nous t'appelons El Shaddai. Sois glorifié, sois élevé. Au nom de notre Seigneur Jésus-Christ, nous prions. Amen.
So we'll begin our readings with the scripture reading from Romans chapter 5. Therefore, since we are justified by faith, we have peace through God. We have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. The word of the Lord. All right, would you stand for the gospel reading, which comes from John chapter 16. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth, for he will not speak on his own, but will speak whatever he hears, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, because he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. For this reason, I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
I love Ron's title, actually, and I think it fits with many messages, actually. I didn't really title mine that way. I titled mine Spirit of Truth, but It's Beautiful, Isn't It? Is also very appropriate. So in our gospel lesson this morning, Jesus is continuing to give last-minute instructions to his disciples as it is his time to leave his earthly, as his time to leave his earthly life is fast approaching. And if we were to back up a bit in our scriptures from today and go back into chapter 14, Jesus tells his disciples that he will not be with them much longer. And then he gave them some last-minute instructions. He told them, "All this I have spoken to you while still with you. But the Counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you things and will remain with you." In today's reading, we hear Jesus saying, "I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of Truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth, and he will declare to you the things that are to come." This truth to which Jesus is referring to is the Holy Spirit. And at this time, the disciples still have not fully understood what Jesus is trying to tell them. They've been with him, they've seen him perform miracles, and they know he has gifts that no one else has had. Something that had to have come from God. And yet the disciples clearly don't grasp who Jesus is and his connection to the Father. And I believe that Jesus could see this, and that's why he said, "I still have many things to say, but you cannot bear them now." They weren't ready for the full impact of what was to come. Jesus had spent a tremendous amount of time preparing his disciples for the life's journey. He knew they would find a way, that they would find the way ahead difficult without him by their side. And that's why the disciples were promised the Holy Spirit. Jesus is protecting them, knowing the Spirit will be gentle in moving forward when he is no longer with them. This wonderful Spirit of God still takes us by the hand, still walks with us, still equips us, still journeys with us. When relationships break down, when jobs disappear, when finances become tight, when illness strikes, and many other challenges that come our way, we need all the help that we can get. And God has given it to us by sending his Spirit. God's gift to you and to me is the Holy Spirit. He fills us with his strength, he equips us with his gifts, and he leads us into his truth. He walks with us side by side, and he holds our hands. And now I'm going to share three different illustrations with you. When J. Wilbur Chapman, a Presbyterian evangelist, was in London, he had an opportunity to meet General Booth, who at the time was past 80 years old. Dr. Chapman listened reverently as the old general spoke of the trials and conflicts and the victories. Then the American evangelist asked the general if he would disclose his secret for success. He hesitated a second, Dr. Chapman said, and I saw the tears come from his eyes and steal down his cheeks. And then he said, I will tell you the secret. God has had all there was of me. There have been men with greater brains than I, men with greater opportunities. But from the day I got the poor of London on my heart and a vision of what Jesus Christ could do with the poor of London, I made up my mind that God would have all of William Booth there was. And if there is anything of power in the Salvation Army today, it is because God has all the adoration of my heart, all the power of my will, and all the influence of my life. Dr. Chapman said he went away from the meeting with General Booth, knowing that the greatness of a man's power is the measure of surrender. General Booth allowed the power of the Holy Spirit to guide him. He saw what was around him, and he knew it was a call to action. He trusted God's Spirit to direct him. And now my second illustration. In the world of technology, there is a development called hypersonic sound. The inventor, Elwood Woody Norris, has engineered sound waves to travel like a laser beam for about 150 yards. This allows sound to be heard by a person in a particular place, but not by those immediately around him. You could be listening to music or specific instructions while those standing next to you would be left in total silence. If you move out of the tightly formed path of these unique sound waves, you too will be unaware of any noise. God's communication with us is very similar to these sound waves. We must be in the right place to hear the Holy Spirit. And when we're there, the message is clear. If we move away from the pathway of His voice, we become unaware of the fact that He is communicating with us, and we consequently miss the message. And the last one, the story is told about a little boy who was flying a kite. It was a windy day, and the kite kept going higher and higher. Finally, it got so high that it was out of sight. A man passed by and saw the little boy holding on to the string. The man could not see the kite, and he asked the boy, "How do you even know you have a kite up there?" The boy replied, "Because I can feel it." Although we cannot see the Holy Spirit, we should be able to sense His work in our lives. The Spirit worked through William Booth and led him to action. The Spirit works with us when we stay the path and listen for the message. And with the confidence of the little boy with the kite, we can feel the Spirit within us, prompting us to live as Jesus taught us. In the Romans passage read earlier, it tells us that the Holy Spirit is the means by which God's love is poured into our hearts to comfort and strengthen us in times of challenge and need. In my message to you on June 2nd, I told you that the Holy Spirit, Jesus' gift to us as well as to His disciples, is that part of God that resides in each of us. It is the connecting thread by which we have our relationship to God and to Christ. Jesus told His disciples He was sending the Counselor, the helper who would guide them and always be with them. And it is the same for us. The Spirit that lives within each of us is there for support. The Holy Spirit is there to help us to see the world the way God sees the world and to use our gifts to further the kingdom. All people have a desire to be loved and cherished, and when we treat those around us with love and care and look for the stranger among us, we are letting God's love shine through us. The Holy Spirit is the beautiful golden thread that is woven within all of us that makes us brothers and sisters of the kingdom. So I challenge you to take time to listen for the message that comes to you through the Spirit. And with the confidence of the little boy with the kite, allow yourself to feel the Spirit within you, knowing that it was Christ's gift to you while his physical presence is no longer with us. Blessed may it be. Amen.
Thank you.
what we have as we come forth with our offering.
Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. All through the night, I'm gonna let it shine. All through the night, I'm gonna let it shine. All through the night, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is all right, a good, a joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
You formed us in your image and you breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets, who looked for the day when justice would roll down like waters and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream, when nations shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore.
And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and joy the unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ.
Your Spirit anointed him to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives, and recovering sight to the blind. You set at liberty those who were oppressed, and to announce that the time had come when you would save your people. He healed the sick, he fed the hungry, and he ate with sinners. By his baptism and suffering, death and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery and sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. And at his ascension, you exalted him to sit and reign with you at your right hand.
On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and in thanksgiving as a holy and a living sacrifice in union with Christ's offerings for us as we proclaim the mystery of Christ. Christ has died.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on the gift of bread and wine. Make them before us the body and the blood of Christ, that we may before the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the glory,
and the glory forever.
Amen.
The table is ready. We can feast together.
The body of Christ,
even for you.
The body of Christ,
even for you. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you give yourself to us. Great that may be the Lord. We give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
So, well, as you leave this place, go with the love and light of Christ within you and sense that Holy Spirit working, and go in peace. Amen.